Hello there, I have bad news. Our Ford Focus has a fault that might be incredibly expensive to repair. In fact, it might be so expensive that we either have to scrap the car or sell it for peanuts. We just don't know yet. So, in this video, I'll show you our Ford Focus, demonstrate the fault and try and figure out what to do next. Don't worry though, it's only money and look, I've got £2.27 right here. Well, it's a start. Welcome to CarSpyTV. Right, this is our 2005 Ford Focus 1.6 LX Petrol Automatic. It's been in the family for many years and it's a fantastic workhorse that's coped with children, dogs, family holidays, extreme weather and even a crazy driver that crashed into it and dented the wing. How irritating. Anyway, the Focus has now covered 111,000 miles, it has full service history and is in good overall condition. So, what's the problem? We're now looking at the dashboard and note what happens when I start the engine. There are two error messages, transmission malfunction, that of course refers to the automatic gearbox, and ESP system fault. ESP stands for Electronic Stability Program and it's a safety feature that helps the car maintain a safe line through corners. Now, as you know, sometimes a car can show you an error message but it feels okay on the road. It drives normally. Not in this case though. Our Ford Focus feels very, very sluggish. Hang on, I'll come to a complete stop and show you. Now, in a moment, I'll press the throttle all the way to the floor and accelerate as fast as possible. You'll then see how slow the car is. Are you ready? Steady and go. That's 10 miles per hour. 20. And finally 30 miles per hour. That's far, far slower than typical and it makes it harder to emerge from busy junctions, join motorways and that sort of thing. And there are other symptoms too. For example, the car jolts when I select drive or reverse on the gearbox. I'll show you. Can you see the jolt? It's perhaps more obvious if you look at the wheel. When the car's working properly, it doesn't jolt at all. Also, the electronic stability program can't be turned on or off and, for some reason, the fan that cools the engine spins at full speed at times when it would typically spin far slower. So, I'm going to take the car to our usual mechanic and see what he says. Okay, so I'm back from the garage. The mechanic plugged in his diagnostic computer and he said the transaxle control module is faulty. That's an electronic part that helps control the automatic gearbox and I know they can be very expensive. They can be four figures. That might be more money than it's sensible to spend considering the car's age, mileage and value, so maybe it will have to go. Anyway, for now, the mechanics cancelled the error messages and the car is behaving normally, but I don't think that's going to last. I suspect we've not seen the end of this problem. So, what we're going to do is test the car over the next few days and see what happens. Hopefully we'll be lucky. Fingers crossed. Right, it's a few days later and the car's been behaving perfectly until this morning. Now, both the error messages and all of the associated symptoms are back. That's irritating but, unfortunately, quite predictable. So, I've been back to our usual garage, but this time the mechanic's computer couldn't cancel the error messages. In other words, he couldn't simply press a few buttons, as he did before, to make the car work normally. Furthermore, the mechanic's computer wasn't capable of precisely identifying the fault. He therefore wasn't sure whether the transaxle control module itself has to be replaced, whether it can be reprogrammed, or whether there's a less serious related issue. Bottom line, this car has to go to a Ford specialist. Come on then, let's phone one. Okay, so I've spoken to a guy at the main dealership and he was genuinely very helpful, which is good. Now, he confirmed that if the transaxle control module does have to be replaced, then it's £1,000 just for the part. On top of that, there's a £105 diagnostic fee, plus, of course, any labour to install the new module. So, as suspected, this repair could cost a fortune relative to the car's age, mileage and value. However, there is some hope. The mechanic also said that the fault might simply be caused by a wiring issue, and that's far cheaper to fix. And that's as far as we can go for now. The car's booked in at a main dealer so we can get a definitive diagnosis and a definitive price. We can then decide whether to fix the car, scrap the car, or trade it in for, I don't know, a helicopter or a space rocket, something like that. So, I'll let you know what happens in a future video, and if you subscribe to my channel now, you'll be informed when I release that video so you don't miss out. Right, that's all for now. Where can I get a big pile of money?